in the raw.
Dearest beloved divine friends, family, brothers and sisters, in the raw. Your friend, your brother, me, Haji Dr. Roshan Khan, RK Guyana Free Media. I have with me today the Chronicle newspapers. And I think this problem is being exposed in all the various newspapers. And it is painful to see that on page 19, the APNU+AFC's McDonald are allegedly trying to derail education cash grant distribution. Here you have a government of the country creating systems by which people can get benefits and facilities. And we seem to have an opposition who is dedicated to wanting to make poor people and people in general and even our country a miserable country. The People's National Congress parliamentarian, friends and families, ladies and gentlemen, doing some of the most ridiculous things, and these kind of instructions, these things cannot come from an individual by themselves. They have a party kind of paramountcy behavior in them. And for her, this member of parliament, Coretta MacDonald, had to have come from the opposition leader, and even maybe the leader of the People's National Congress, to try to sabotage the cash grant. I'm no political person, but I'm a commentator. I'm a respecter of all the citizens of this country. I'm a lover of this country. And how dare they try to sabotage and prevent the people from getting benefits of my tax dollars and yours that the government is managing and want to give the poor people of this country. And the government doesn't even discriminate. Once you are a child in the school and you have a home and you have facilities and benefits to receive, you receive it. And we have many poor people in this country. How can Coretta MacDonald, obviously working on behalf of the leader of the People's National Congress and the leader of the opposition in Parliament, to be allowing these things? How come the PNC has not come out and condemned it? Our PNC used to be my friends, you know. It's only now they're annoyed at me because I exposed the attempt to rig. I cannot stand against law and order. I gotta stand for law and order. How can they do something so mischievous and ridiculous to make people's life difficult? I recall Corbyn, you know. You people in the PNC need to study Corbyn, you know. Corbyn would have been made one of the mightiest rulers of presidents of this country and was one of the greatest and wisest PNC leaders. He told the people, if they're giving you something, it's painful. Very, 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 very painful. So here is the article. I want to do it here for you. The parents of over 172,000 learners will tomorrow, for the first time since 2015, begin uplifting their Because We Care grant. One of the first things the APNU did in taking power was withdraw the $10,000 cash grant. They took it away immediately and gave nothing. What they did for their supporters, they gave them a couple of slap. You all voted for us. You got the people you want in power. And therefore, you got to listen to us. And what did the leader of the opposition at that time said when he was doing some trash and some nonsense and being rude? The leader of the opposition, now guy, Joseph Armand, what did he say? We have no apologies to make.
You have to pay people well if you want them to perform. I'm not going to say that I make any apologies whatsoever for ministers getting an increase in salary. They deserve it.
What kind of a thing is that? Forbes Burnham and Desmond Hoyt must be turning in their grave over what they have there as leader of the opposition. Though this initiative, which was resuscitated by the government, serves as a means of alleviating some of the financial burdens on them, they are purported efforts afoot to derail and obstruct the distribution process. Reports seen by this newspaper claim that a Partnership for National Unity, Alliance for Change, APNU and AFC parliamentarian, and General Secretary of the Guyana Teachers Union, Coretta McDonald, has sought to discourage teachers from participating in the distribution of the grants. Coretta McDonald, who is also General Secretary of the Guyana Teachers Union, a teacher union representing educators, trying to prevent the distribution. Ladies and gentlemen, saying this thing cannot be her alone. Because if I was the opposition leader there, I would have fired her from her seat. It has to be centrally controlled and directed from the leader of the party and from the people or the persons who are leading the opposition in parliament. Disgraceful. Back to the article. McDonald, by virtue of her position within the GTU, has influence in the public school system. According to the claims, she solicited the support of teachers in derailing the exercise, which is seen as a crucial initiative at this time, because the COVID-19 pandemic and other external shocks have driven up the cost of living. Now let's hear what our Honorable Minister Manik Chan is going to do. Education Minister Priya Manik Chan, in a post on her Facebook page, said, "It is bizarre to me that any person or political party or any of their affiliates would object to Guyana's families being assisted with 19,000 per child." Not per home, you know, I said per home earlier, per child. So if they have 5 child in school, 3 child in school, 10 child in school, it's almost $20,000, $19,000 multiplied by that sum. What does Mr. Harmon, what does Coretta McDonald, what does the Chief Whip, Christopher Jones, what does the Don Duncan, what do they want? The people to go to their offices at the PNC headquarters or the AFC and beg? You guys have your means of owning money. How these people are getting an opportunity through our amazing government, when your party, when you were in power, stopped it, pulled it off, and here they're getting $19,000 by the number of children, and you want it to be stopped? The people must not get benefit out of it. You want to sabotage them? This Coretta McDonald should be charged criminally for sabotaging the benefit of the people. Oh yes. Oh yes. The Guyana Chronicle has made several attempts to contact McDonald for a response. Education Minister Priya Manik Chand, in a post on her Facebook page, said, "It is bizarre. Brilliance. The attorney at law. The minister of several ministries is saying, Honorable Minister Manik Chan, the beautiful lady of wisdom, it is bizarre to me that any person or political party or any of their affiliates would object to Guyana's families being assisted with $19,000 per child. But then it was bizarre too that Guyana was forced to wait 5 months after our election to have a legitimate government." So these are the people, how they are. They're bizarre. They've lost their friends. They've lost their sense. They've even lost their own supporters. While not referring specifically to the claims being made against McDonald, Minister Manishkin said the APNU and AFC just doesn't do anything sensible, logical, or lawful. Correct, Honorable Minister. Reject them as they try to deny you this grant. We are here, and we will bring you this goodness. Every public school child, because we care. See you when I come into your community. You know, Madam Priya Malik Chan, Honorable Minister, if you want somebody to walk with you, I'll go with you. I'll lend you my presence and support, and even my protection, even though you don't need it. I support you. I support your government. Reports are that the Because We Care grant is valued at $15,000 this year, while the school uniform and supplies grant is valued at $4,000. This means that each child in the public education system will be entitled to $19,000 per child. Parents, pray for your government, regardless of ethnicity or religion or political party. Pray for your government. Remember, those of you who are supporters of the APNU, that the PNC, as soon as they took power, they stopped the payments. For 5 years, you got nothing from them. Only the big boys got lands, properties, money, barbershop, $20 million worth, barbershop. Never used it, took the money. Lands, friends, family, sell, oversell. Only them were the big shot. Indo-Guyanese businessmen who were financing them, they got all the benefits. What did you, the poor supporters of the PNC or the APNU+AFC got? You got fired, laid off, fired from your job, closed down sugar estates, money not circulating, and Guyana got abject poverty out of them. Approximately 172,000 learners are set to benefit from the program, bringing in the overall cost of $3.2 billion. Our tax dollars, $3.2 billion to the people of this country. I'm proud. This is how I like my money to be spent. And unlike last year, this school uniform and supplies grant will not be given in the form of a voucher, but rather in cash. Cash. They can take their money and go buy what they need for their families. And we just increased last year from $2,000 to $4,000. The Ministry of Education said that it aims to serve each child before September 2021, when the new school term is set to begin. The initiative of the government of Guyana is to provide assistance to families so they can provide the necessary resources to their children so that they cannot only remain in school but also excel in their studies. The ministry said the Because We Care grant was initiated by the People's Progressive Party civic government. Prior to demitting office in 2015, at the time, the program afforded each child in the school system $10,000. That they had done it. But in 2015, as the people, we did that before. And as soon as the APNU got in power, ladies and gentlemen, they stole it. They stole the money to put into programs to help their friends build barbershops and to own expensive lands in the East Bank for their friends and families and build billion-dollar houses, friends and families. The program was implemented with the aim of providing support to parents and school-age children and increasing their disposable income so they can get money to spend. With a view of increasing school enrollment and attendance rates across the country so that people could get an education, and those who can't are not fully set for high-tech education, they can also be trained for trades. When the APNU and AFC assumed office in 2015, it discontinued the grant. I just said that. As soon as they took power, ladies and gentlemen, they stole the money from the people and they put it into programs to help their friends and families to get rich and to build barbershops. During the lead-up to the March 2nd, 2020 elections, the BBC had promised to reinstate the program. They have, and they've erased it. Thank you. This has since been reintroduced by Minister of Education Priya Manikchand and the Irfan Ali led government. The government has also committed to increasing the Because We Care cash grant incrementally each year until it reaches $50,000 per child. The aim is, I think, as early as possible to take this up to $50,000 per child in school. Per child, not per household, per child. $50,000 each in time. I salute His Excellency the President, Dr. Himar Jagdeo, Minister Priya Manikchand, and this PPPC-led government who truly care about the development and the growth and the betterment of our country. Your friend, your brother, me, Haji, Dr. Roshan Khan, in the raw. Say thank you and farewell.